Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with the 13th chapter of microwave engineering, where the measurement with respect to the various performance metrics of the microwave propagation is to be carried out. We started this chapter to see a comparison of how the low frequency measurement and the microwave frequency measurements are different. So the comparison was seen, and we started to have the introduction to the very popular microwave component essential for the measurement, that it is slotted line along with the tunable detector. VSWR measurement technique we have carried, along with introduction to the practical VSWR meter. We have solved few of the selected problems to make calculations for the VSWR measurement, various meters corresponding to the power, and some others we have been reported so far. Now let us have in this chapter the measurement for attenuation. So here we start with our topic. The topic is titled attenuation measurement. So whenever we have our microwave signal to be propagated, right, it is generated at the microwave source up to the microwave load, the propagation of the microwave signal is governed by gamma, that it is the propagation constant in terms of alpha plus j times beta. So for propagation to occur, ideally the beta, the change into the phase accounted into the phase shift constant, is very important. So it should be non-zero value, and ideally the alpha, which is called as the attenuation, that should be equal to zero, but practically the attenuation occurs here. So therefore the measurement of the attenuation should be very important to us, hence this is the topic here. Now basically the phase shift constant we measure in terms of radians, we have the change into the phase here. So next to that we have the another component to get the complete information for propagation. So this is the attenuation constant, and the attenuation constant is most possibly computed in terms of the decibels here. For the attenuation in general, we can make the mathematical form for the definition, that it is 10 log to the base 10, if you want to take it into the decibels, the ratio of P suffix IN to P suffix OUT. So here P suffix IN corresponds to the input power, whereas P suffix OUT corresponds to the output power. Generally for any of the electronic device or circuitry, we want it to be efficiently working, and for that we want the gain to be as higher value as desired here. So the gain is of course the output power with respect to the input power. Here it is the reversal, as attenuation is a kind of loss and reversal quantity as compared to the gain in general or efficiency in general, we can see here. So this important equation will be very important to design a method for the measurement of the attenuation here. So there are two methods to make the attenuation measurement possible. The methods are called as power ratio method and that of the RF substitution method. So one by one we shall be discussing them. So we have the first method, power ratio method. So by using the power ratio method for the measurement of attenuation, whatever the device we are going to have for the attenuation measurement to be done, we have the assembly for the system where we get that particular component included into the system as well as excluded from the system. The corresponding power measurement we do, and from the difference we can have the attenuation calculated here. So let us go through the schematic diagrams for the two cases. So we can treat this schematic diagram as setup one for power ratio method. Now you can see here We start with the microwave source at the left hand side, isolating it from another devices by the pad. That it means it is the isolator here. Here we have the frequency meter. I hope you are now well familiar to the slotted line. The slotted line which is giving us the opportunity and the platform to have the measurements inside the rectangular waveguide here, and which is finally terminated there. Now on to the slotted line, there it is a mounting of the crystal detector which shall be making the measurement of the voltage levels, and it shall be providing to the thermistor mount and finally to the power meter, so which will be reading the power denoted by P1 watts for the setup one. So in this particular setup, for the device where we are going to make the measurement for the attenuation to be calculated here, the device is not at all included in this particular method here. So we have the initial power calculation excluding the device for which the attenuation measurement is to be performed here. Now in the same power ratio method, we have the second assembly. We can name it to be the setup to power ratio method, where we have the assembly allowing the device whose attenuation is to be measured that has been connected in this particular total assembly here. So we have same other devices used here. We start with the microwave source, isolate it from the other devices so that it could not be damaged because of the reflections. We have the frequency meter. After frequency meter, we connect this device whose attenuation is to be measured here. We have the slotted line and terminate it at the end. Onto the slotted line, mounted a crystal detector giving input to the thermistor mount here. Finally, at the power meter, we get the reading for this setup 2 denoted as P2 in terms of watts here. Now the difference of the two powers, one without the device connected into the microwave test bench setup for which the attenuation is to be calculated, and the second setup including that particular device, we have the two powers P1 and P2. So the difference or the comparison of the two should be giving us the attenuation level. But to see a plot of input power represented P IN and the output power represented P OUT, we find a non-linearity into the input and output powers here. So this is the graph here. Now on this graph, we have the marking of power P1, we have the marking of power P2 also. To see this non-linearity, we come to have a conclusion that if we use the power ratio method where the input power is at the lower values and the effect of attenuation is more, so that time the attenuation measurement will be the inaccurate one. So therefore there it is a need to have one more method that can have the drawback of the power ratio method eliminated there. Hence the another method is by the name, we have the second method called as RF substitution method. So in the RF substitution method, to make the attenuation measurement possible, we are again going to have the two setups, but instead of having not at all using the device that is meant for the measurement of attenuation here, we shall be making the use of precision type of the attenuator here. So first of all, we shall go through the first assembly that involves the network or the device which is intended for the measurement of the attenuation. So the assembly is given in the block diagram. So here we have the assembly that starts with the microwave source, the isolator denoted by pad here, frequency meter, the network or the device whose attenuation is to be measured here. We have a slotted line, the termination at the another end, the crystal detector mounted onto the slotted line, and finally the power meter that is measuring the power level P here. Now here it is the another assembly in which we have the microwave source, the same, the pad that is isolating the microwave source from reflections of the other devices, frequency meter. Now in a place of the device that has been connected to measure its attenuation, we have the use of variable type precision attenuator here. So the precise variation of the values of attenuation we can achieve here. We have the slotted line, termination, mount of crystal detector and the power meter. Now the thing to do in this RF substitution is method is to have the tuning of the variable precision attenuator so that whatever the reading of the power into the earlier assembly that we have seen in RF substitution method, including the device at this particular place, we had the reading of power meter denoted by P. So same power reading P is to be obtained by having the tuning to this variable precision attenuator here. So when the tunable precision attenuator is tuned to that particular value, we obtain the same amount of power and it does has the scale. So onto the scale, we can mark the attenuation value. So as compared to the power ratio method, where the P1 and P2, the two different power readings we had to make because of the non-linearity between the input and output powers, the method was inaccurate. So that drawback has been removed by taking the RF substitution method, where the power reading at only one value denoted by P is made possible by using the variable precision attenuator. So this was all about the attenuation measurement here. By the next lecture, we shall continue with the same chapter to see the phase shift measurement possible in this chapter. So I hope you shall be subscribing to Ekeeda channel for more details and the knowledge if you want to have for the microwave engineering subject. Thank you.